My first hot take is that Kirill Kaprizov will win the Hart Trophy this upcoming NHL season. And here's my rationale, okay? Last year, you know, of course, Austin Matthews won the Hart Trophy, had a phenomenal year, scored 60 goals, but there were some other big names who were in the running, and you know, believe it or not, Kirill Kaprizov was one of those names. He didn't finish top three. He ended up finishing, I believe, seventh in Hart Trophy voting, but he was at least in the conversation among the hockey writers who do vote on this trophy. So last year, Kaprizov had 47 goals, okay, 61 assists for 108 points in a full game or a full season played, so 81 out of 82 games. And also, through six games in the playoffs, he had seven goals, an assist, and 8 points. So, amazing playoff as well. Not that that matters for the Hart Trophy, but just kind of, you know, showing how crazy of a player this is. Like I said, he was seventh in Hart Trophy voting. Right now, he's plus 1,400 on all of the major sports betting platforms, which ranks him fifth in voting odds among all players in the NHL for the Hart Trophy. So fifth, there's definitely some good value there. You know, the likes of Connor McDavid, Austin Matthews, Cale Makar, I think Nathan MacKinnon are so I think those are the four above him. And he ranks fifth at plus 1,400. A couple weeks ago, I put $10 on Kaprizov to win the Hart Trophy at that number, plus 1,400. So this is something that I've believed in for a while, and it's going to be kind of my horse all season as we go along here. Now, the rationale, why I think, you know, he's going to improve from that seventh spot in voting to number one. Well, this year, something different compared to last year is that he's not going to have his running mate, Kevin Fiala, beside him. So, you know, some people might look at that and think, you know, maybe that means his production will take a bit of a dip. And fair enough, that could be the case. But I just think if Kaprizov can put up another season with similar numbers, breaking 100 points again, scoring 50 goals, because remember last year he had 47, was very close. If he could put together a season like that and kind of drag Minnesota to the playoffs. You know, a lot of people are saying that Minnesota might take a step back without the scoring of Fiala. So if he's able to drag them to the playoffs and have another incredible year without the guy who finished second on the team in scoring last year, Kevin Fiala, I think that makes a really good case to the writers for him being the most valuable player to his team, which, to remind you, that is the definition of the Hart Trophy.
Yeah.
A couple other things here, and then I'll let you jump in, get your opinion. I'm going to need a drink of water here soon. Zuccarello was one of the only other players on the team last year who was over a point per game. It was Zuccarello, Kaprizov, and Fiala. So he'll still have Zuccarello on that top line with him, which is a plus. But I don't think people look at players like Zuccarello or even some of the younger guys coming up on the team like Boldy or Rossi as real like drivers, you know. Like, I feel like for the Hart Trophy, the argument always gets made, whether it's about Connor McDavid, Leon Draisaitl, Austin Matthews, etc., that, you know, they're only one piece of the puzzle on a top line, and they get extreme amounts of help from other players who they play with. So that kind of goes against them in their quest to win the Hart Trophy. But I don't think Kaprizov is going to have that argument made against him this year, because it looks to me, anyways, when I look at this team on paper and in their top six forward group, it seems to me like Kaprizov is on a bit of an island by himself as the sole driver, the sole producer, the guy who's going to be looked to really carry this team offensively. So that's really my argument. The final thing I'll say is that Dom Lecision, as we know from The Athletic, runs a pretty accurate model for fantasy projections, team scoring projections, and, you know, is the big numbers guy, basically, at The Athletic. He projects Kaprizov to score 44 goals, 51 assists, and 95 points this season. So of all the projections of total points for players, Dom's is the one I trust the most. So with all of that combined, it seems like Kaprizov is poised to have another great season with less help on a team who is expected to take a step back, and I think he'll be able to will them to the playoffs. So that is my big rant, Harp. That's my argument for why I think Kirill Kaprizov could win the Hart. Now I want to hear your thoughts, because that was quite a lot.
No worries. I like it. I think Kaprizov is a driver, and he is a superstar now in the National Hockey League. And that was a pretty wide open Hart Trophy race for a big chunk of the season last year. And I think we could see the same kind of thing this NHL season. And the odds are certainly there for Kaprizov a little bit down the list. Like you said, at plus, was it plus 1200 or 1400?
1400.
That's 1400.
Right.
Yeah. So, you know what? I like those odds, man. And yeah, he's going to have to be a driver offensively for Minnesota, who I still think is a good team. I know that there are some doubters out there with the cap situation that they're in. But with a young player like Matthew Boldy, who came in and was just fantastic. I mean, you've got Eriksson Ek, who's a very defensively responsible center and can win a lot of faceoffs and that. So I think Kaprizov is going to be just fine. And it's still a good team, and he's a driver for them. The guy is just absolutely electrifying to watch. And so I like it, man. I really do. If Minnesota is going to make the playoffs and continue to push and be a contender, even with the salary cap situation that they're in, Kaprizov is going to be a huge part of that. So I like it.
Yeah, I look at this season that I'm expecting from Kaprizov this year, this Hart Trophy caliber season, as, you know, comparable to Taylor Hall a few years ago when he won the Hart Trophy on a team who, you know, like, I guess the Devils at that point weren't really expected to be very good, and Taylor Hall did, you know, put the team on his back and get to the playoffs. So it is a bit different, but I see them kind of the same. Like, you're relying on one guy to sort of drive your offense, and like, believe me, I'm not trying to take anything away from other players on Minnesota. Like, even a guy like Ryan Hartman had like 65 points last year.
Yeah.
You know, and like you said, Boldy, when he played, he stepped up. You know, I think he had over 30 points in like 45 games or something. So, like, they've got a lot of guys. So, I'm not trying to take anything away from those players. I just think, in terms of high end talent, there's really only that one guy. Like, you know, you've got your players who can sniff a point per game, but, you know, I feel like every team has those players. You just, you know, not every team has a Kirill Kaprizov, a guy who can get, you know, this year, depending on how the season goes, 115 points, you know, like he had 108 last year. Yeah, 108. So,
yeah,
115, I don't think is out of the question. And if a season like that comes from Kaprizov, man, I think I'm going to be in the money here for him winning the Hart Trophy.
Geez, yeah, that could be a nice payday for you there, Chad. And you know what? If we continue to see the level of offense that we did last season, which I think we will, like, there's just, you know, the guys are just so good now, and they know how to score goals. I think, yeah, I agree. Like, over 100 points again for Kaprizov, and for maybe multiple seasons to come, is not out of the question. The guy's a superstar.